because property management companies use QuickBooks a little bit differently, this means recording bounced checks are just a little bit different in this file. What should you do when a tenant bounces a check? Well, you have to record the reduction of your bank account on the same date that the bank recorded the reduction. It has to be the same amount in total that the bank deducted, and when you're recording it, you have to split the amount between the amount of the bad check and the amount that the bank deducted from you, because, you know, the fee that the bank charged you because the tenant gave you a bad check that you deposited into your account. And then, of course, you have to record that you actually earned a fee from the tenant for your troubles. And of course, this will be more than the amount of the bank fee that you deducted. And you also have to record that the tenant owes you number 3 plus number 4. The tenant owes you the total amount that they were supposed to, the original check, plus the fee that you earned. So these are the 5 corrections you have to make into your records, and you can do it all in one shot. So first, you have to set up for this, or set up for bounced checks in a management company, property management company, by adding 2 accounts to the chart of accounts. We're going to add bad check fees earned, and that's an income account, because you're charging more to the tenant than your bank is charging you, and you want to track the amount separately. And you have to put receivable for bad check fees. In other words, we're going to put the money that's owed to us for bad checks in a separate receivables type of account, and that will be separate from their normal rent balance, and that will be separate from their normal security deposit balance. So let's take a look how to put on these 2 accounts. So from the main menu, we click List Chart of Accounts. And then, of course, we already remember, we might make this lower, we already remember from the bottom left, Account New. The first one is an income type of account, and we call it Income from Bad Check Fees. And then we click Save and New. And the second one is an accounts receivable type of account. And we call it, what do we call it? Receivable for bad check fees. So we can just basically call it receivable for bad check fees. Okay, good. Save and close. Now all we have to do is, after we did these 2 things, add a special bounce check receivable report to the icon bar. Well, we already know how to do that too. We know that comes from the specific report, customers and receivables, customer balance detail. Now, what we would do is we would customize this report, and we would filter it by account, and the particular account that we would filter it by would be this accounts receivable account, receivable for bad checks. Now, when we click OK, it's going to be empty because right now we don't have anything receivable for bad checks. But you should also maybe customize the title of it and call it receivable for bad checks. And when you save it into the icon bar by clicking View, Add to the icon bar, you could also call it receivable for bounce checks. Okay, there you go. So this will show you, it's a little messed up, but it'll show you only the money that's owed and specifically for bounce checks. So now let's take a look at our example. Let's imagine on June 1, we received and deposited $3,000 from Candy for June's rent. 10% is our fee, and she gave us check number 8472. Now, we already know that this is Candy's first payment, and we already know how to record deposit from collections, but we'll put the date that we got the money, it went into this bank account, we received it specifically from Candy Charles with check number from Star Trek 8472, if you're a Janeway fan. And the account this time is the normal account that we would normally do. In other words, this would be the payout to the clients, to landlord clients, would only be $2,700, because that's 90%. And of course, from Candy, we earned the income, which is income from management fees, and that would be the other $300. So we already knew how to record that, and here's the $3,000 that we physically received on June 1, and we think everything's fine with this check, and we click save and close. Now, you may well notice that we now have a balance of $2,700 to remit back to the landlord of Candy at the end of the month if we don't have any expenses related to Candy. You will also notice in the trial balance, the bank account, if I double click, it has increased by the deposit on June 1 of $3,000. So we think our records match the bank. However, what will happen now is June 4th, we receive a notification that as of that day, June 4th, the bank account is decreased by $3,030. And you say, hey, why did you decrease my bank account by $3,030? And the answer is, there's a bank fee of $30 because your customer bounced the check on you, and $3,000 we took out because we should have never put it in the first place on June 1 because it was a bad check. So that's the explanation of the $3,030. It should be noted that we actually charge $55 to the tenants who do this to us, who bounce a check on us, as well we should for our aggravation. Therefore, the total that the tenant owes us is $3,055. So these are the numbers that happened in the situation, and therefore these are the numbers that we will put in when we make a general journal entry. And it is very simple to make a general journal entry, and we will simply refer back to these numbers in the PowerPoint as we record it. What date should the general journal entry be? The date that the bank decreased the account, because that is also the date that we earned this $55 that the tenant will pay later as a fee for the bounced check. So it's very simple. We click company, make general journal entry, and we put the date that the bank put when the bank reduced the account, June 4th. Okay, now I'm wondering if I could maybe make this look nicer. I want to see more. I guess it's, what is it? Collapse this. There we go. Okay, good. Now, obviously, the bank account has decreased by $3,030. So you have to put a credit to the bank account by the amount the bank decreased it, so that it matches the bank. So that handles this here on this $3,030. Now, what about the fact that $3,000 was the bad check and $30 was the fee? Well, let's just record the fee for a moment. Expenses are always debited when you incur them. So we will come here for the bank fees. And because I forgot to put it on the list before this video, I'm just going to put this expense called bank fees. Thank you for waiting while I put it in the chart of accounts. But the bank fees will only be the $30 of the fee that they charged. Now, stay with the story. Because even though we know we have to split it between $3,000 owed and $30 as the fee, we should also charge the $55 that we earned, even though we haven't received it yet. And if you record expenses as always a debit, you have to record income as always a credit. So very simple. We go on the credit side. Ooh, wipe this out because they're trying to help us. They don't know. Put $55 because that's the amount we earned in income from bad checks. So do we agree now that we earned $55 in income from bad checks? We incurred $30 of bank fee as an expense. The bank account was decreased by the $3,030. So the remaining balancing amount, by chance and coincidence, is exactly the amount that the tenant actually has to pay you. Because they have to pay you $3,000 for the check and $55 for the fee. So the amount that they owe you goes into this account, receivable for bad check fees. Receivable, it should really just say receivable for bad checks in general. So this is how much is owed to you because you earned $55, they bounced $3,000. This will properly adjust the bank account, and this will record the bank fee. And that's all you have to do. So if here are the numbers in the situation, and you can pause the video and look and think about it, then this is the way you would put it in. And this is a model example of how to do it. Now, click Save and Close. In other words, it's telling us, you have to choose a customer with a receivable account. And in this case, QuickBooks has to know that it's Candy Charles, specifically Candy Charles, that will pay you for this receivable in the future. Save and close and take a look at the numbers. The trial balance indicates that specifically related to bad checks, you are owed $3,055. The bank account has been properly adjusted for the amount that the bank adjusted it on the day the bank adjusted it, and bank fees are increased by the amount that the bank took out. If we go to pay out to landlords, this affects her balance because we didn't really adjust. Really, we should go to this new receivable. See, this receivable for bad checks will show this. This we have to fix. We'll just fix this so it will not show the bad check receivables. The bad check receivables are here on a separate report. Just Candy owes you the $3,055. I'm going to make a little correction here so that it would not show up on the regular rent report. It doesn't show up as affecting what you would remit, although it might. It might be in your arrangement with your landlord that you're not going to pay your landlord if your tenant bounced the check. So you might want to leave this here until they finally repay. Now, when they repay, just choose the receivables account. So June 9th, for example, Candy was nice and she paid you $3,055 with check number whatever. Well, that's very simple. You still click deposit, you'll put June 9. The amount that came into your account was $3,055, and you received it from Candy. Don't worry about that. You received it from Candy, but the account, the specific account, because this $3,055 was related to bad checks, you put it here. And then when you click Save and Close, and you look at the bad check report, you see on the one hand she owed it to you on the 4th, but then on the 9th she paid it to you and she owes nothing, and that deposit increased the bank account, and everything is right with the world.